Hey guys, welcome to this session by Intellipaat. In this session, we'll be learning how to install Ansible on top of AWS. We will install Ansible on master and configure SSH access to Ansible host. And before we move on with this session, please subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss our upcoming videos. Now let us begin with this session.
So the first step that you have to do is you'll have to install Ansible on the master, right? But you do not have to install Ansible on the slave. That's because Ansible works in such a way that, you know, Ansible installation is just required on the master. On the slaves, it just requires Python to be installed. If Python is installed, it can directly connect to that particular Ansible slave, right? So this is the first step. First step is install Ansible on master. Second step is to configure SSH from the master to the slave. That is, you should be able to do an SSH to the slave from the master without any key and without any password. So we'll see how we can configure this. Third step is that we'll have to set up Ansible host and then we'll have to test the connection. All right. So we'll do this step by step, guys. So let's start with step one, which is install Ansible on the master. Now, in order to do that, you'll have to first launch two instances on AWS. Now, let me just quickly jump on to my AWS console. So guys, this is my AWS console, guys. And the first thing that I have to do is I'll have to launch an instance. And the OS that I want is Ubuntu. The processor would be t2.micro. I click on next. What are the number of instances that I want to launch? I want to launch two instances. I'll click on next. Move to the part where you'll have to select the security group. Now, if you don't have a security group, first create a security group and add a rule for all traffic. And it should be basically from anywhere. Click on review and launch and this will be done. If you already have a security group which has these kind of properties, what you can do is you can click here on select an existing security group and select the security group that has all the rules according to what software you're installing. All right. So once this is done, guys, click on review and launch. And finally, review all the settings that you have done and click on launch. Okay. Select the key pair that you have on your system and click on launch instances. And this will launch two instances on AWS for you. Next step would be, guys, to basically go to my management console and naming my instances. So let's call my first instance is as Ansible 1. And let's say my second instance is Ansible 2. Okay. Ansible 1 is going to be my master and Ansible 2 is going to be my slave. Let's try connecting to Ansible 1 first. So I'll go to my PuTTY tool and this already has my my PPK file selected, which is HEM, right? So this is already selected. Now I'll click on open. So I'll click on yes. And I have successfully connected to my master now. Awesome. So I have connected to my master. The next step would be to connect to my slave. So for connecting to my slave, again, I'll go back to my management console, select the second instance, copy the IP address, open a new PuTTY terminal, put the IP address over here. Let us change the color so that we can differentiate which one is my master and which one is my slave. And yes, now we are basically connecting to my slave. Let's enter the username and we'll select successfully connected to my Ansible slave as well. So my green terminal is my Ansible master. This is ready now. And this is my Ansible slave. Now, what are the next steps that I will do? First, I will have to update the master and the slave. So on my master, I'll type in the command sudo apt-get update. Similarly, on my slave as well, I'll type in the command sudo apt-get update. All right. So my machines are now getting updated. Once I've updated my master, next step would be to install Ansible. And for that, the commands are these, right? So once you've updated the machines, you'll have to install a package called software properties common on my master. Usually when you're launching an instance on AWS, this package is already the latest version. So as you can see, it says it's already the newest version, which is awesome. The next command that you have to run is you'll have to add the repository for Ansible in your master, right? So just type in this command, hit enter, and this will basically add the Ansible repository to your master. Next step is to update the machine. So let's update the machine with this command. So it says sudo apt-get update, machine is updated. And now finally the command to install Ansible, hit enter, and Ansible will now be installed on this particular machine. So while Ansible is being installed on this machine, guys, what do you have to do on the host or on the slaves? You'll have to update the machine, which you have already done, and just install Python. Okay. So this is my master. Ansible is successfully installed on my master. On my slave, I just have to install Python. Nothing else. No other Ansible software. So Python is being installed on this machine now, and Python is installed successfully. Okay. So Ansible is installed on my master. Python is installed on my slave. These both are ready, right? Now let's see what is our next step. So let me just go to my slides. So the first step was to install Ansible on the master. I've done that. Next step is to configure SSH access to Ansible host. Now, what does this particular step mean? This means if I go to my master right now, and if I type in the command SSH Ubuntu at the rate, the IP address of the slave, I will not be able to connect to my slave right now with this command. Let's see. Let's verify this. So I'll go to my AWS management console, and this is the IP address for my slave. Let's try to copy that over here. Let me also explain you what is basically happening in this command. So I am doing an SSH on this machine with the username Ubuntu. Okay, so that's why Ubuntu at the rate this IP address. Now, if I hit enter, if I just type yes, this is basically asking, should it add this IP address in the list of known IP addresses? I just select yes, and this IP address will now be added. I hit it enter, and now as you can see, it says permission denied. So you're not able to do an SSH to this instance with this particular IP address. Now we have to solve this. This should basically be a success. This should be able to connect to the slave through this particular command. Right now, why are you getting permission denied? That's because the only way to connect to that instance is using the PPK or the PEM file, right? We don't have the PEM file in this instance. So we'll have to enable my slave to be able to accept connections from this particular machine, so that it does not require any key like a PEM file or a PPK file or any kind of password. Now, this is a necessity when you're trying to install Ansible. Now, let's see how we can do this. How can we enable keyless access into my slave? Now, for doing that, guys, the first thing that you'll do is you'll have to go inside the directory .ssh. Once you go inside that, let me first show you the structure right now. If I do an ls, you can see there are two files. One is called authorized keys and the other is called known hosts. What is known hosts? When we were executing this particular command, ssh ubuntu at the rate IP address, it asked us whether this IP address should be added to the list of known hosts, right? So inside this known host file, if I do a cat on known hosts, you can see that this is basically the code, or this is basically the encrypted form of this IP address that is that on the slave, and which tells it that, okay, so this is a known host that I'm connecting on. Okay, if you don't understand this, guys, don't worry. This is not a part of you getting to know Ansible. I'm just telling you this for your knowledge. All right, so this is encoded form of the IP address that you'll be connecting to. All right, what else is there in this directory? You have something called as authorized keys. Authorized keys is a file wherein you will be entering all the machines which can connect to this particular system, right? If I do a cat on this file right now, you would be able to see that this is the SSH, or this is the key code that of this particular file. What is this file? This is the PEM file that got downloaded on my system when I created a key pair, right? So when I connected to this instance, I connected using this particular file. So this is there in the authorized keys file, which means that if a machine is connecting to this particular instance and has this particular file as an argument, in that case, that allow that machine to connect, right? So if I remove this, nobody will be able to connect to this instance, even if they have this particular file. Okay. Now what I want to do is, on my slave, if I go to this particular directory .ssh, and if I do an ls over here, this file that is the authorized keys, I want to add one more key in this, which will basically allow my master to connect to my slave. Now, which key I have to add, I'll tell you now. Now, in order for you to generate a key for your system, all you have to do is type in SSH-keygen. This will basically create a key for this particular machine. It is going to be unique for this particular machine, all right? So SSH-keygen, if I hit enter, it'll ask you to enter the file in which to save the key. Do not enter anything, just hit enter repeatedly, right? And then once you get this kind of a message, that means your file has now been successfully created. And where is it created? It is always created inside .ssh directory. Okay, now if I do an ls over here, I can see there's a file called id_rsa.pub. Okay, now the code which is there inside this particular file, I'll have to put it inside the authorized keys of my slave. Okay, so let's try to do a cat on id_rsa.pub. This is the code id_rsa, sorry for my mistype. This is the code which we have to enter on my slave now. Okay, so let's copy this code. And on my slave, let me do a nano on authorized keys. And now let's just paste the code over here. Okay, we have pasted the code. Let's save the file. And now if I try to do an SSH again from my master, I should be able to do it successfully. So I'll just again go to that particular command. This is it, right? Let me copy this command and let me clear the screen, guys. So I'll clear the screen so that it's visible clearly. Now I'll do an SSH on this particular IP address. And now you can see I didn't get an error. I basically got logged into my slave. And how do you know that? This is the username @IP172.31.45.176. This is what you're getting on this terminal. And if I see over here, I have the same number over here as well, 172.31.45.176. So I'm connected from this machine onto this machine through SSH. Now, if you want to exit the SSH, all you have to do is type in exit. It says connection to this IP address has been closed. And you can see it has reverted back to the same name that was of the master, which is IP 172.31.44.88. Earlier it was 172.31.45.176, which was of my slave. Okay, so I have done my second step successfully, which was basically to configure SSH access to my Ansible slave without any password and without any key, right? You just enter SSH Ubuntu IP address of my slave and you'd be able to connect to it successfully. Now, what is my third step? My third step is setting up Ansible host and testing the connection. So I have SSH enabled on my master. It can easily connect to my slave now without any password and without any key. But how will Ansible connect? We'll have to configure that now, right? Now, in order to add, or in order for Ansible to know that it has to connect to a particular machine, it has to have its IP address, right? Now, where can you add that IP address? That IP address is basically added in this particular location, /etc/ansible/hosts, right? Hit enter, and this is the file that will come up, right? So these are all the commented lines, are all the templates that you can use to basically add hosts, but I'm going to tell you a new template in any case. So the way you add hosts is you start by square braces, okay? And inside square braces, you give a name. Let's say the name is production. What does this name symbolize? This name means that whatever is below these square braces is basically inside the group production. So this is the group name, okay? And now what I can do is I can add n number of IP addresses over here, and all those IP addresses basically will be inside the production group, okay? You can name your group anything, guys. It's basically random. You can name it anything, but whatever IP addresses you will specify after that will get inside that particular group. Okay, now I have created a group. Now I want to add a host inside this group. So I can give my host a name as well, or I can give my slave a name as well. So let's call my slave as slave1, right? Then you'll give a space and then you'll type in Ansible_SSH_host is equal to, and then the IP address of your slave. So in my case, the IP address of my slave is this particular IP address. Let's try to copy it and let's enter it over here. Okay. So you enter the group name, then you enter the host name or the slave name, paste Ansible SSH underscore host equals to the IP address of my slave. So whenever I'll ask Ansible to ping any of my slaves now, it will read this particular file to get to know which IP address it has to ping on. Okay, now let's save this file. So my file is now saved. And now let's try to enter the command Ansible hyphen M. So now what we are trying to do is we are trying to see whether Ansible can communicate with my slave. Okay, now in order to do that, I'll type in Ansible hyphen M ping. Ping means ping that all the slaves which are basically connected to this Ansible master. How are we selecting all the slaves? We'll type in the command all. So Ansible hyphen M ping. Ping on what? All the machines that are connected to this Ansible master. I'll hit enter. So it'll go through that file which we created /etc/ansible/hosts. It will see all the hosts which are added in that particular file, and then it'll ping those machines. Right, so as you can see, it on slave one was the name that I gave to my host. On slave one, it was successfully able to send ping, and what it received was pong, which means that it was successfully be able to communicate with the Ansible slave. All right, I can also type in Ansible hyphen M ping, and I can specify the group name. So the group name was production, let's say. Right, I hit enter. As you can see, it automatically got to know, okay, so if I'm pinging production, these are the hosts which are inside it, and this is the message that you're getting, which is success. If I try to type in the host name as well, so I can also do that. I'll type in Ansible hyphen M ping slave one, which is the host name, hit enter. It'll again be able to ping the slave machine. But let's say I enter a name which is not there in the host file. What will happen in that case? It will not be able to match it to any of the name present in the host file, and hence you'll get an error. No host match, nothing to do. Okay, so guys, this is how you can set up Ansible master slave on AWS using the Ansible software, which basically does not require you to install the Ansible software on the slave. Just install Ansible master on the master, the Ansible software on the master, install Python on the slave, add the IP address of the slave in the host file, and configure keyless SSH access from the master on the slave, and you're ready to go. All right, so guys, with this we conclude our session. So let me just come back to my slide. So let us summarize what we did. We installed Ansible on the master, and we installed Python on the slave. Then we configured keyless SSH access from the master to the slave. And the third step was we added the host's IP address on my Ansible master in the file /etc/ansible/hosts. Right? Once I did that, I was able to communicate with my slave.
Okay guys, we've come to the end of this session. I hope this session was informative and helpful. If you have any queries regarding this session, please feel free to comment it below, and we'd love to help you out. Thank you.